Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be a something a little different. This is my first time I am using my new camera to film a video looking at the camera instead of being behind the camera. Today, I don't know when, but it was recently, we got some news of the new Chronicles of Narnia movie, The Silver Chair. So the two Narnia channels I keep up with are, what are their names? HP of Narnia and Edmund and Lucy. Love the name because I love Edmund. I keep up with, and every time I see a video about Narnia or whatever, I watch it. And I guess the director of Silver Chair was at Paris, Joe Johnson, and I've done videos on him over the past. It's kind of big. Like I said, I got into Narnia last year. I saw the first movie a couple times in the theaters, I think two times, but I was so young then, I didn't really understand it, and I just really understood the fantasy part of it. I didn't really understand the emotion and story of it. When you're a kid watching those movies, you just really only understand, like, the magic part and the good versus evil. Other than that, you don't really get what they're trying to tell, but I seen the first one, and I decided last year, you know, I never seen the first and third one, so I went in, I watched it, and I loved them both, even though with Prince Caspian, it was just a little too long for me, because there was, like, so many times where I thought it was gonna end, and then they keep going, and sorry, I have a, zit there, pretty bad infected, so sorry if it looks weird. In 2010 they did the Dawn Treader, and that was the third movie, and it actually just had Skandar Keynes and Lucy in it. Susan and Peter were not, well, they were in it. There was, like, a scene with Susan writing to Lucy, and then there was a dream scene where Lucy wants to be like Susan. I didn't really like that, all that, but since then, that was the last Narnia movie, and there are 7 books, and there's only 3 movies. This is Lion, Witch, in the Wardrobe, Caspian, and Dawn Treader. I know a lot of people didn't like this, but I actually really liked it. I actually have 3 copies of this. Well, one's on Blu-ray, so so yeah, but I just love, you know, when there's emotion in stories, in movies, especially movies that are like sagas or trilogy, and I just felt the emotion. So anyways, Joe Johnson was in Paris at Comic-Con, I guess, and he was got asked about Narnia because he's the new director, and I guess he said filming can start next year. I thought they were already starting to film, but they, I guess not. I thought they were going to start filming this year, and then it would be out by, like, next Christmas or something. But I guess not. That kind of is a bummer, because I'm really interested to see how this movie will be done. And he also said, which this part kind of, I'm bummed. He said it's going to be a kind of like a whole new movie. It's not going to be referenced any of the other past 3 movies. It's going to be a new cast, new crew. But technically, Silver Chair is supposed to be a sequel to this. So I don't really quite understand why. I mean, I understand changing Narnia, because honestly, in all 3 movies, Narnia was different. It, you know, the first movie, it was the winter, and it was different, but it still had that Narnia feel to it. And I get changing Narnia, fine with that, but I honestly, in my opinion, think the other movie should be connected, like, you know, like the other movies, because it's part of a story. I mean, he pretty much said it's going to be like a new reboot. And then I go back, I kind of say, well, if you want to reboot something, just go back and remake the first movie then. And then start your... He could have remade the first movie, the second, third movie, and then he could have had his own trilogy. I think that would have been a little better, in my opinion, if he just kind of recreated Narnia and not make a fourth movie and not connect it. So that's a little... I'm a little bummed about that. I just hate when things aren't connected when they are supposed to be. Like in Star Wars, Force Awakens, they did reference the prequels a little, but not too much. I'm a huge fan of the prequels, so, they did a little, but they mostly referenced the original trilogy, which I think, you know, any other movie in any saga or trilogy should, in my opinion, always at least be referenced, even if it's a little one. So that's a little annoying to me. And I get he wants to be, you know, he wants it to be this new, whole new thing, and just new, and he doesn't want anyone to, he doesn't want to go back and, he doesn't want to, you know, copy the others. But it's not really a copy. Like I said, it's supposed to be a sequel to Don Treader. I just would have preferred at least if they kept Don Treader connected. I wouldn't mind if they... I mean, I would be okay if they didn't connect the other two movies, but they should at least connect the last movie. And then a whole new cast is going to be, in it. There will be none of the original cast, which kind of sucks because, I am totally in love with Skandar Keynes right there. I call Skandar Keynes my celebrity husband, because I just love him, and I really love his portrayal of Edmund. You know, in the first movie, he starts out as this brat, but I still love him. And then he makes a mistake, then he realizes his mistake, and that's just what kind of made me fall in love with him, and he makes up for it in the end. And I'm really sad because Skandar, he actually gave up acting after this movie, and now he's in, like, politics and government in London and stuff, which, you know, I want him to do what he wants to do. As much as I would love to see him return as Edmund in a Narnia movie, I don't think even Edmund's even in the Silver Chair, so that's okay. But for future Narnia movies, I would love to see, you know, Skandar return. I just love him. He's amazing. So that would be pretty amazing. But I respect him, and I respect that he... I don't know if he just lost interest or, I know he didn't really like being famous and so on and so forth, but I love him, and Edmund will always be one of my favorite characters. And I understand because Skandar is 26 now, and he's older, he's not a kid anymore. So unless they want to bring, like, the kids back as older kids, I don't know. But I will miss him. And then another one I will miss, and she was really only in the first movie, but she did make cameos in the second movie, is White Witch. I think... Here. She's right there. Right there. I think the White Witch is the best villain of the trilogy. The best. I mean, the king in the second one was okay, and there wasn't really a villain in the third one, but except that green mist that, you know, I loved in Don Treader when the White Witch does appear, and she's trying to taunt Edmund, and that was a great scene. But I think the White Witch is the best villain. I just loved her. Tilda Swinton was amazing as the White Witch. She and Skandar Keynes worked great together. Even though it makes me sad to see Edmund tortured by the White Witch and stuff, I still think their acting together is phenomenal. And I just think Tilda made a really good White Witch. And I know a lot of people, like some people like the BBC versions, and I also do have those on DVD, but I did watch some of the first one, and it's just a little out of date for me, and I honestly can't picture these characters, like Edmund, Lucy, Susan, White Witch, Peter, as anyone else but the actors who played them in the movies. I think it was perfect. So I guess filming can start sometime next year, and then I guess it's going to be out by maybe late next year, early 2020. It's coming, but it's just going to take a slow time coming. So let me know your thoughts on what you think of Narnia the Silver Chair, and let me know if you've seen any of the other Narnia movies, and if you're a fan or not, or if you haven't seen them, I do highly recommend them. If you're looking for a good fantasy, you know, they're not, you know, they're kind of like Lord of the Rings style with big battles, fantasy, but they're not as high scale as Lord of the Rings. I mean, because Lord of the Rings is huge, but they're up there for me with Lord of the Rings. They are definitely up there. I love both, so. So let me know your thoughts, and let me know what you're looking forward to the most to see in the Silver Chair movie. Are you excited? Are you sad because, no, it's going to be new, it's not going to connect any of the other movies? Or are you just going to go in it with an open mind? I am going to go with open mind. I'm giving it a chance as a Narnia fan, and I really believe Joe Johnson is going to do great in this, even if it doesn't connect the other movies. I think it will still be good, you know. Just because it doesn't connect doesn't mean it's not going to be good. So that's going to do it for this video. Please let me know your thoughts down below. As always, all my information is down below. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day.